Recycling is so important because a massive amount of material, meaning the things that you put in the recycling are trash. If you put recyclable material in the trash, it's going to the landfill. And the landfills are filling up super fast. Really, what should be in the landfill would be true trash, which is things that you can't recycle, you can't reuse, and you can't compost. So it's really important that you try to recycle what you can. But we want to reduce and then reuse and then recycle. We want to be reducing our waste materials, so trying to buy less things. If you have to buy something, trying to reuse it as many times as possible. And then once that is done with the reusing part, then getting it into the right stream so that it can be recycled. So the first thing to look for when you want to know if something's recyclable is look for the chasing arrows, typically on the bottom of something. And then it's going to have a number on the inside of it, so a 1 through 7. And then know what's recyclable at your house, at your school, in your community. In Ohio, we're really lucky that we have solid waste districts. Not every state has that. And they're going to have an outline of what is acceptable recycling in that area. So that's an easy cheat for people in Ohio. They can jump on their solid waste district website and find that out. Then it is making sure that it's clean, because contamination is a huge issue. If you don't rinse out your recycling, you try to recycle a hummus container. In our area, that's recyclable. But if it still has a whole bunch of hummus in it and you throw it into your recycling, it's gonna get everything all dirty and it ruins that whole batch of recycling. So it's important to know it's recyclable and keep it clean before you're recycling.
This is where all the material comes in. You can see the pile of recycling behind us. So this is the commingled recycling or mixed recycling. And then to the left on the other side, we have source separated cardboard. We get high volumes of cardboard. Historically, cardboard is the most recycled product. But this is the start of the process. As it comes in, the trucks empty out and onto the tipping floor. And over here, we have an in-feed conveyor system. The skid steer with a grapple bucket will feed that into the hopper in the conveyor system. And that starts it into the building to start the sorting process. There's a lot of machines going on, a lot of people doing a lot of different jobs, but a couple of the materials, glass, aluminum cans, and steel cans are all pulled out by machine automatically. And then we're sorting through some of the plastics and the paper and pulling off non-recyclable items. And then we can see the end result, which is a baled material that's compressed with a really strong hydraulic press. Puts it into basically a cube or a rectangle. Once everything's sorted and baled, we see the trailers behind us. We have mixed paper on my left here, and then aluminum cans on our right. And so these are the quantities, full semi-truckload quantities, is what we ship out. And that goes down the line to a different recycling plant where they process it and get it ready to be made into something else.
You really hold the power to make change. If your school isn't doing anything about recycling and composting, you can ask them about that. You can advocate for that. Same thing in your household. You should care because our world is filling up with trash. We're running out of time and we're running out of space on the planet. We have to do better and we have to change our behavior. And the way that we're gonna do that, I think, is by young adults forcing us to change our behavior. So you have the power. Go for it.